Hello, this is Christy. In this very quick tutorial, I will show you how you can perform a clean delete and reinstall of Descript. Sounds like it might be an easy thing to do, but a lot of people have questions about how do you actually uninstall and clean up your entire installation. Because Descript stores files in several folders on your system, simply uninstalling the program and reinstalling it again on top, it will not remove the data that was stored, and you may end up with the same issues that you've had before, because some bugs or some issues require a clean reinstall of Descript. So that means also removing the files that Descript stores, your project media files, your actual projects that do get backed up in the cloud, but they also keep a copy on your machine. So a clean install means removing those files as well as the uninstallation of the program. So let's have a look how to do this. I have Descript open here, and before you even consider uninstalling it, you need to make sure that there is everything synchronized in the cloud. If you delete stuff and it's not synchronized, you will have incomplete files backed up in the cloud and you will lose your data. So to check that, if you open Descript, you have this icon at the top left next to the Descript icon. If you click on this, this is your background activity or sync activity. So you need to make sure that everything appears synced and backed up. You know, all changes are saved and synced automatically when connected to the internet. That's the first thing. If you still see stuff happening here, still activity, files uploading or processing, do not uninstall and do not delete your folders because you will lose your data. Descript doesn't have a save button, which means every time you work on a project or you add any files to a project, it will automatically start processing those files, copying them locally, and then uploading them to the cloud. And everything is kept in the cloud in Descript. If you uninstall it and you install it again, as soon as you open a new project from the cloud, it will download everything from the cloud. But of course, that needs those files to be in the cloud in the first place. So really important, before you uninstall and delete anything, make sure that this background activity here has everything synced and backed up. Next, let's take care of deleting the files. How do we find where the Descript program keeps its files? It varies on Windows as well as on Mac, but usually you find it in the Help menu. If you go to the Help menu, you go to Debug, and there you have Open Folder. And inside of this thing, there's two folders, the App folder and the User folder, okay? Both of these things store data. The App folder stores preferences and things like that, and the User folder will keep your project data. So before you uninstall Descript, just click on these to open them in your Finder or Explorer and keep them open. Here we go, opening the App folder. Here we go. This is the App folder. You see Descript right there. If I expand this window, you see everything that's stored in here, including accounts and blob storage and all those things. That's one folder. And let's go back to Help menu now, Debug, Open folder, User folder. Basically, it's the accounts, the User folder is kept inside of the main folder. So you can delete all of this as soon as you uninstall. Now, let's keep these open. And actually, I can actually click and close this one because the other one is actually kept inside of it. So the accounts folder is the same one as the User folder. So really, this is all the stuff that I would have to delete when I am ready to uninstall. Okay, so I'm gonna keep this open and go to Descript, quit Descript, obviously, you need to quit Descript. I open another Finder window, and on the Mac, you go to Applications, and there you will find Descript. Right click on this and move to Bin. In Windows, you will find it in the Program Files, in the Control Panel, Uninstall Descript. Here we go, move to Bin. The item can be moved because it's open. Okay, one thing you need to make sure is, usually Descript runs in your system tray, so before you quit properly, you need to close that as well. You'll find it in your system tray. It's off screen for me right here, but I'm going to just quit Descript from the tray. In Windows, it's on the bottom right corner of your screen. In the system tray, there's a blue D in there. You need to quit that as well, because that is actually Descript running in the background as well. So now Descript is properly closed. Let's try this again. Right click and move to Bin. Here we go. I have now deleted Descript. But I'm not done here because I have to delete the folders where it stores the data. If a clean install is to be made, I have to delete that data as well to force Descript to re-download it from the cloud. So here we go. I'm going to quit this now because I don't need it anymore. And here I am in the Descript folder in my system. You have the accounts, you have blob storage, all this stuff. Because it's synchronized to the cloud, I don't worry about losing any data. So I will just select these, right-click, and move to bin. Done. So my Descript folder is now empty here. You can delete this one as well. I think it's going to be added back when you reinstall. So now I have removed Descript. I have deleted that folder. I'm going to empty my recycle bin. All right. I'm done. I emptied my recycle bin. Now time to install Descript again. So if you want to restart your computer after you do this, before you install it again, feel free to do that. I honestly don't think it makes any difference, but you know, if you want to do it anyway. And now I'm going to go to the website, descript.com/download. There it is. The download should start automatically. Here we go, it's downloaded and I will click on it to install it. Descript installer is now running. Here we go, you can see that folder that I had open. It created all the stuff back in here, it added it back in. So now all I have to do is log in to Descript, launch it. Here's the window, it's launched. I will click sign in. Obviously, use your account if you're logging in with Google or whatever you're using, sign in. So there it is. I am back in Descript. None of the projects is actually downloaded now because I deleted everything, but, and you can see this cloud icon next to them, which means they're not downloaded. They're just in the cloud. Click to open. There it is. Descript is downloading it, and it's starting to give me all these tips because it's a reinstall, so it thinks I've just installed it for the first time. And now you see the project downloading in here, and it should show my videos soon enough. So this is how you do a clean uninstall, delete files, reinstall, re-login, and there you go. You have a clean install of Descript. Usually this is needed sometimes when things go really badly. Like this week, for example, there was a bug in Descript that requires you to reinstall the whole thing in order to get over that recording bug that was going on. So here we go. I hope this video was useful. If you need help with Descript, feel free to contact me or sign up for my membership, mediamakers.club. It's a membership, not very expensive every month, and you get Q&A sessions with me, access to all of my courses, which includes a massive Descript course and several small mini courses with Descript, for example, creating social media clips, how to use scenes and templates and all those things, plus all of my Camtasia content as well, mini courses, assets, downloadable stuff, and much more. So, you know, if you would like to consider that, check out the link below, mediamakers.club. I hope to see you there. And if you need one-on-one coaching with me, I can teach you Descript from scratch. And also, you find a link for that in the description. Hope to see you soon. Thank you for watching.